Good evening po sa inyong lahat. So the gospel mentions three basic Christian practices, and they are fasting, praying, and almsgiving, or giving alms. One time or the other, we have practiced this as Christians. No? Regularly, we fast and we pray and do good works through almsgiving. However, today's gospel cautions us that this should be performed in secret. So may warning na binibigay. These things must be done in secret. For the Father who sees in secret will repay you. This line is repeated 3 times after mentioning each practice. Now, what does doing things in secret imply? Lahat na lang ba nang gagawin natin patago? Okay? Umahilig tayo sa secret. Ayaw natin ipasabi sa iba. But then, my dear friends, we cannot help it. It's no secret that right now you are in front of me attending Mass and I am also before you. Merong mga CCTV dito, no? So it's no secret that we are here and we wish to pray and worship God. Now, if you come to think of it, a good number of our Christian practices are public or communal in character. Now, does this verse, the secret, or doing things in a hidden manner, apparently, it contradicts verses in Matthew chapter 5, verses 15 and 16. What does it say? It says the following, and I quote, "No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under a bushel basket or under a bed. Otherwise, it's useless." Di po ba? Kaya ka nga nag-iilaw. "It should rather be put on a lampstand so that it gives light to all in the house." And then it says, "Let your light shine before others so that they may see your good works." So nasaan na yung secret doon? Nasaan na yung hidden? Now, probably we can ask ourselves, meron nga bang contradiction yung gospel ngayon, where everything is done in secret, at saka kay Matthew verses chapter 5 verses 15 to 16. Now, in order to reconcile this seeming contradiction, we go back to a key word in our gospel today, and that word is again secret. The key word in our gospel today is secret. Secret is associated with our intentions, okay? Intentions in praying, fasting, or giving alms, or doing good works. And intentions usually remain in the private domain. You don't tell people why you are doing a good work. Okay? You don't go around the compound telling people why you are here. Kasi yung intentions, they remain personal. They remain in the private domain. Only the person, himself or herself, knows the reasons behind his or her actions. And God, of course, knows our intentions, because God is the only one who can read minds and hearts. So probably, we can always go back. Ano bang intention natin? Why we pray, we fast, and we give alms? Are our intentions geared towards one's glorification or self-advancement or selfish ends? Or is there something higher? Okay? Beyond the self. Now, humanly speaking, of course, there are no pure intentions. There are no pure intentions. We are not angels. Tao tayo eh, no? Kung gumawa tayo ng isang bagay, okay? Deep within us or behind us, sa background, meron palaging, whatever we do, there is always an expectation of repayment or an ROI, okay? Return of investment or any return, whether in the form of appreciation, a praise, or self-satisfaction, or carrying favors from somebody. I scratch your back and you scratch mine after some time in return for what I did to you. Now, however, as Christians, the overriding intention behind our actions, whether private, in secret, or in public, is to give glory to the Father. And the Father who sees in secret will repay us. Amen.